In this lesson, we will see how to configure a TypeScript project file. It's time to get back to the tsconfig.json file which we had created while setting up the project. Now the tsconfig file is just a regular JSON text file. This file also has content in form of key value pairs just like any other JSON file. This stores information about how our project should be compiled, so we don't have to add the compiler option again and again while we run a compiler. We can specify the list of files to be included or excluded in this file while we compile a project. Best of all, the TypeScript project files support configuration inheritance. This means in a large project, we can create a tsconfig file at the root of the project, like here, which will hold the default configuration options we want to apply to our project, whereas we can have a separate TypeScript project file in different folders in the project. For example, if we have one here in the app folder, this will selectively override or add to the options in the root project file. We will see how to set such kind of configuration inheritance in a few minutes. Let me show you a list of compiler options available to us from the TypeScript official webpage. In the Docs tab, if you move down to the project configuration section, TSC CLI option. In this link, you can find the alphabetical list of all available options. Here you can see we have a help option which gives us local information for help on the CLI. Let's move to VS Code and see this in action. In the terminal, when I type tsc-h and hit enter, it gives me the list of all available compiler options. So this was about the compiler options. Coming back to our tsconfig file, we had created this file using the command tsc-init. If you want, you can remove this entire code and write the only options which you need. But we will stick to use this file by commenting out the options which we don't need and uncomment the options which we need. We had made a few updates in the first lesson. We will do some more now. The first we will see is this target option. This specifies the version of JavaScript which will be output by the TypeScript compiler. ES2016 is widely supported by all browsers, so we will leave it as it is. Next, this compiler option module was commented out in the earlier lesson. Going further down, here we have the sourceMap option. SourceMap was enabled in the earlier lesson. Then next I'll uncomment this out directory option. This specifies the output directory in which the compiler should save the compiled JavaScript file. I'll set it to a folder named JS. It doesn't exist yet, but you will see how the compiler creates this for us. Next, I'll uncomment this strict option. The strict option enables all strict type checking options, and this is helpful in pointing out the potential errors in our code. You'll see the effect of this soon. We have another compiler option here, esModuleInterop. This is related to modules, and I'll turn it off for now. And at the end of this, I'll add the watch option. This leaves the compiler running so that it can automatically recompile the source files as they are saved. This saves a lot of time during development. Add a comma here after the previous option, and we are good with the watch option. This curly braces marks the end of the compiler options object. There are other things which we can specify inside this config file. That was it for the config.json file for now. Since we have the out directory as the JS folder, we no longer need the main.js file which was created earlier. So I'll delete it for now. And now from the terminal, I'll compile our project. Now after the settings that we have done, we don't have to run the compiler from the directory which contains the tsconfig file. The compiler will look for the file in the current directory. If it doesn't find one, it will move up to the directory hierarchy looking for one. So we are here in the Quick Math app and not in the app directory. We are using the configuration file now, so just type tsc and hit enter. Now the compiler is running on the watch mode, obeying the configuration option we had set. And here we have got an error when we turned the strict option to true. Here it says the object is possibly null. If they are null at the runtime, our app can blow up in the browser. For this demo, we know that the messages element and the start game elements does exist in the HTML. I'll quickly resolve this by adding a non-null operator here. And I'll speak more about the strict option later in this course. So as I added the operator, the code got recompiled and you can see the error disappears in the terminal. We also have a JS folder created here for the JS output file and the source map file. To use this newly compiled JS file, we need to update the script tag in the index.html file. I'll minimize this terminal. And in the index.html file, I'll update this location to use my main.js file in the JS directory. We will start the server, add a new terminal, npm start, command click. And now we have got the updated files here in the browser. In the Chrome Developer Tools, in the Sources tab, you can see here is my main.js file. And here is the main.ts file. Now in this main.ts file, when I add a breakpoint here on line number 4 and hit the start game button, you can see the browser is executing the JavaScript file. And I have added the breakpoint in the TypeScript file. When I hit the start game button, the debugger stopped at this breakpoint. So you can use the Chrome debugger tools as well to inspect the code. Click the continue button and allow the code to finish running. So we have a working project configuration file and we are able to debug our code in the browser. Next we will see how we can use multiple configuration files to control more precisely how our files in particular directory are compiled.